It worries me, worries me, worries me. If it wasn't for deportation, if he stayed, really stayed, not go to Germany in a few months, he would be here. He would be in Poland, and he could walk down the street, and the sun could shine, and maybe it would be summer. And he would walk the street, and he would pass people and shops, and would stop at a traffic light and go somewhere, and then go somewhere else, and that's all. He would be in my country, maybe not in my city, but in my country. And I don't know if I want that. Actually, I know, I don't want him. I don't want him to walk, to pass, to stand, to have the sun shine on him. It's too much responsibility for an official. I don't want to take responsibility for his presence here. I have a wife and children. My parents are still alive. I have friends and theater tickets tomorrow. I can't risk it.
That's why migrants are free. Run, there is no more Germany or Agorai. Run not into your wife's arms, run into the arms of women and men. Run into a world without wives and husbands. Manly women, womanly men, run into a world where nobody runs anymore.
They came. They tied my hands. They tied my legs. They laid me on the floor, stomach to the floor. One of them on my back pressed my right cheek firmly to the ground. The other wrapped a piano string on both of his palms and stretched it between his hands, approached my head and began to wind the string around my neck.
The European Council of Refugees and Exiles Statement, 26 October 2016. The Afghanistan Donor Conference that took place on October 4 and 5, 2016 brought together representatives from 75 countries and 26 international organizations. 13.6 billion euro was pledged among other priorities to quote-unquote end violence and political process towards lasting peace and reconciliation. In this context, imposing non-voluntary returns onto an already fragile situation puts in risk the rights of the returnees as well as the overall efforts to promote stability. It is essential that European aid to Afghanistan is used to ensure peace and security and to rebuild the country first and foremost. The EU must uphold its own obligation to respect, protect, and promote the human rights of migrants and refugees. The European Parliament must effectively contribute to any discussion on bilateral political agreements in order to ensure that they address the needs of vulnerable people, do not facilitate violation of human rights and international law, and take into account the concerns on civil society.
Thank you. Thank you.